Welcome back to the channel, everyone. It's been a while. Hey, I just want to give a little video update here on the Balding Palms Railroad. Not too much has been going on, but I did want to, we did a few little upgrades here that I wanted to show you. If you're familiar with the Girvan Junction, I improved it a little bit. I moved a signal. I used to have a signal, I think it was in this general area right here, and we moved that over to this side over here, and we also incorporated the lower spur. That has a solid red on there right now. So those two signals are the east end of Girvan. So Girvan covers the whole Dogbone loop here now, and also covers the siding coming into where the brewery and the packing house are. And here is the west end of Girvan right there. So we also applied 12 volts to that, so we have constant voltage. And we also did that to the upper loop as well. Here we have the upper loop, and we also converted that to 12 volt operating power as well. When I mean by 12 volt operating power, that's just power going to the Arduinos that are operating the systems. If you look in here, it looks quite a bit different. I actually sold all of my Lionel TMCC controllers and bricks. I have one little brick down there that I haven't sold yet, but all the controllers, since all the locomotives are now on battery power, there was no need for those for that control system. I am planning on moving over to Rail Pro to convert some of my legacy TMCC engines here in the future. This is the 12 volt system over here, running off of a 12 volt battery that has a little 20 watt solar panel over here in front of the layout. And I installed this. These are the power switches for the signal lights. And this is the Arduino Nano that is operating the upper loop. I also forgot to mention, I did upgrade the circuitry on the Girvan and the upper loop. So now the train can exit and enter either direction once the blocks are clear. So meaning that the train, if it comes in through the east, it could exit the east and clear the signal once it clears. I did that both on Girvan and for the upper loop. Next on the agenda is to convert the crossing gate here. This is operating on a 9-volt battery, actually, and I do have power basically right underneath here that I'm going to run some power the same, and then add, I had one more switch over there in the car barn to add the crossing gate to 12-volt power. After that, this winter, actually, when the weather gets bad, we're going to pull in all of the station, the brewery house, the packing house, and we're gonna revamp those a little bit, probably give them a new coat of paint, maybe put some more doors in there, and just liven them up a little bit. They are a little bit faded, and so we can have some fresher looking buildings. Oh, let me show you the Girvan Junction here. So both of these are operated by if you can see, these are the HCSR04s. Those are ultrasonic sensors. And in here is the controls. That's where the Nano is, and that's operating on a 12 volt power. And that's a reset button right there. If we run out of sync, we just push the button, it will reset it back to highball green. So. Well, I'm going to run a few trains here for you, and again, thanks for joining me, and stay tuned for some more updates coming along soon. Now we're moving into the upper loop. blinks a few minutes, and then it clears to green. Now we're approaching Girvan. Once we hit the signal, we'll drop the red. All right, now we're gonna exit Girvan. It'll stay yellow until we clear. All right, there you go. There's Girvan. All right, so I'm pulling into Jackville Junction here. I gotta do a reverse move. Got to go all the way over to the ore mine and drop off those two empties. Shoving the caboose back because we're going to shove with the caboose. All right, made up our train for a reverse shove. Got the caboose there. Gonna be our lead unit right there. Here we go. Now we're coming into Matthew Mine. We're gonna drop off two empty coal cars here. Dropped off two coal cars. Now we got two box cars and two hoppers and the tank unit. That all gonna be dropped off at the brewery and the produce spur. And then we're done for the day. Here we go. Pushing into the brewery and drop off the tank car and two hoppers. And the two box cars are going to go to the produce store, produce warehouse. as you can see, Girvan is all red because we're working the siding here. All right, so now we're going to leave Girvan here, and you'll see it should go to yellow. And we're going to head back to Jackville Junction for the night. That should turn yellow or turn green soon, right? As soon as it clears a little bit. There, and then now we're clear. All right, pulling in the Jackville Junction. Hey, thanks for sticking out to the end today, and stay tuned for more updates coming up soon on the Baldy and Palms Railroad. Again, comments are always welcome. Hit that subscribe button if you're new to the channel, and leave a comment if you want. I answer everything I can that is left to me. And thanks for joining me, and I'll see you next time.